YNC Improv is doing a show.
YNC Improv? What have they done this whole time?
Hey, Chris from 2013 and the class of 2017. You know what we should do?
Yes, Kevin from 2013, what should we do?
We should start an improv troupe.
An improv troupe?
Yeah.
Wait, but are you sure people will want to join?
I mean, we'll get at least 4 people, right?
4 people? Yeah, but do you think it will really last that long?
No, come on, it's gonna last at least 10 years. Maybe even 12 years, who knows?
Okay. Well, so what do you think we should name it? Oh, I know, I know. You know, we're in Yale-NUS, and we're gonna form an improv troupe.
I got it.
So.
We should call it Improv Yale-NUS. Cut to 2013.
2023, actually.
2023. Oh my god, we're 10 years old! Woo! Improv is 10!
Yes, that's right. We have managed to last for 10 years, thanks to a lot of support from the Yale-NUS community, so many incredible alums who have paved the way for us, and of course, all of the incredible logistical support that we get from SAO, CATS, MICE, and always our incredible audience. Both in person and on the live stream, who has supported us show after show for so long. We really appreciate it.
Now, hang on, Lydia. This show is called Improvocene. Now, I know what Ocene means, but what is improv?
10 years! It's been 10. Whatever. For those of you who don't know, improv is a form of unscripted comedy where we basically make up scenes on the spot using nothing but prompts from you, the audience. So everything that you'll be seeing today in this show will be done for the first time ever and the last time ever. So keep your eyes peeled for this once-in-a-lifetime Improvocene show.
And just a reminder for the whole audience, remember to put your phones on silent mode or do not disturb or airplane mode or whatever you need to do. No notifications. Yes.
Yeah, just don't bother us.
Yeah. Don't interrupt the art.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, in any case, as with all improv shows, we need to have a way of coming up with the prompts. But we also need a way to store them. I mean, you have so many prompts from the audience, so many prompts from the troupe, but how would we store all the prompts to use for the show?
Well, we have this thing that we've been using for the past 10 years, and it's called the word jar. Can we bring out the word jar?
Oh, it was just there the whole time.
Okay. No, all right, bring it to the front, please. All right. Okay, so inside this word jar are going to be all your prompts that you're going to be giving us for the show today. Why not we do a little warm-up exercise? So on the count of three, everyone shout out a word, a phrase, or a prompt for us, and it's all going to go into this word jar. Okay, ready? One, two, three.
Horses, dogs, food, fruit.
Whoa. Okay, stop. Okay. That's scary. Okay, get it out of here. You're just...
Okay, here's good.
Okay.
All right, now with the prompts, without further ado, let us start Improvocene, and we'll begin with our first game of the night. Rotate, Sabrina.
Hello, everybody. So, I have the great honor of starting the first game of the night, and with that, we have our three players who are already conveniently assembled. Callista, Lydia, and Mani. Excellent. So our longtime audience members will know this game. It is called Rotate, as was introduced. And essentially, I'm going to take you in a little bit of channel surfing. Now, I know it's a bit of a foreign concept these days with the streaming, the YouTubes, all that. But I'm going to bring you back to the era of TV. Our players are going to arrange themselves into an equilateral triangle. Thank you very much. Very lovely. Okay. And each pair of players will be playing one genre of your choosing. So, for our first pair of players, Mani and Callista, may I have a genre from the audience? Can it be any? Oh my, so already. I feel like I have a long-term audience member right in front of me. Okay, Shakespeare. We can work on some more, just like. Whoa. Try it. Oh. Reality show, zombie. Zombie Shake, okay, I heard two very different things which I'd like to put together. Zombie and Shakespeare. So Mani and Callista, your first genre will be zombie and Shakespeare. Rotate! Our next pair of players, Lydia and Callista, may have more genres.
Jane Austen.
Okay. K-drama.
Animal Planet,
okay. TED Talk, okay. I heard Animal Planet, I heard K-drama. I'm in a bit of a mixing mood today.
Sabrina!
I'm feeling a little bit of, perhaps, I want to say like K-Animal Planet, but I'll give you something a little less, I'll give you Animal Drama your genre. Are you guys okay with that? Doesn't matter, it's my game. Rotate! Okay, our last genre for Mani and Lydia. We do have a documentary already. Blue's Clues. Oh, hold on. Okay. Okay. Can I just get a couple more from the audience? That was a very big mess.
Reality show.
Workplace drama reality show. Fiction tournament. Ooh, tournament. I like tournament. What kind of tournament, though?
British Bake Off.
A British Bake Off. Oh my god, the British Bake Off. I love the British Bake Off. Okay. I want you guys to do a cooking tournament. Any cooking form you like, I will give you that bit of freedom. You don't get much. So, can I have one object to tie the three genres together?
A broomstick.
Broomstick. Lamp. Wow. That sounded... Sorry? Okay, I heard Rubik's Cube from somewhere in there. I like that. So your object is Rubik's Cube, okay? So we're going to rotate one more, and we're going to go through the genres just to make sure everyone's up to date. So our first genre, what was this?
Zombie Shakespeare.
Very good. To rotate. This one.
Animal drama.
Excellent. Rotate. That's the one. So, without further ado, players, enjoy.
We rotate us one more time.
Oh, yeah, rotate again, sorry. I am in control of the TV remote, that's my bad. Okay, take it away.
All right, could we have the scene lights, please?
Oh. Thank you.
Ooh, ooh, yeah.
Edward! Thou Edward? Thou West Edward. Thou West. Est. Thee. Romeolet. Thy hand looketh scrumptious.
Oh!
Thy seems to have trouble speak a thing. Thy smitten. Thy hand looketh scrumptious.
Sorry, my bad. Hi, I'm a giraffe. You're really tall.
What can I say?
I'm Sparrow. I love your spots.
I love your feathers.
Thank you. I clean them every day. But what are you doing here?
Reforestation.
Wow.
Yeah, I love the planet.
That's so noble. Hey, sorry, can I use your oven real quick?
No! Get your own oven!
Sorry.
Damn it!
No, sorry. Sorry.
I'm trying to make this Rubik's soup.
No, yeah, of course.
It's got lots of moving parts. Gotta make sure they all fit.
Well, if you need help with anything, you know, I kind of can't really do anything until my stuff is in the oven, so I just have, you know, free time if you want to, you know.
Your stuff's in the oven already?
Oh, man. I gotta hurry up.
Hey, could you help me?
Yeah,
thank you. I need more blue.
I've got all of the colors, but, well, I'm not sure how you want to organize
them. Yellow and green. Oh, but they make blue when they're together. Wait. Yeah!
Yellow and green! That is exactly how colors work.
Rotate!
I apologize to thee for my Looking at your hand as scrumptious. It is okay. I looketh at your hand for marriage. Thee wishes to marry me? Thee does. Oh. Alas, we are of rivaling houses.
Indeed.
Oh, what shall we do?
Rubik's Cube?
Indeed. Shall we consume it together? We faketh our deatheth. Yeseth. Three, two, one.
Rotate!
And so, that's the story of how my family lost their nest.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. And that's why I'm here, for reforestation.
You're here to help?
Yeah.
All we really need is for as many leaves to stay in the trees as possible.
Oh, for as many leaves to stay in the trees?
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, we can do that, we can do that.
Yeah, no, right?
Yeah.
Would you like to grab some dinner together or something? We can eat some worms, you know, get close to the ground.
Worms, close to the ground.
It'll be fun. We could enjoy ourselves. Yeah?
Okay.
Why don't you seem enthusiastic?
Oh, I have to tell you something.
What?
I eat leaves. Rotate!
We cut to presentation of the dishes.
Yours looks really good. I'm really rooting for you. I hope for the best.
I know. I made it myself with no help.
That's not very kind of you, you know.
Why?
Well, there's a lot of rounds of this, okay? It's a tournament. And so, you know, just because we're going head to head doesn't mean that we can't just be kind to each other so that we don't get a bad reputation down the road.
You got a point.
Yeah.
I do not want a bad reputation. I'll do this for me.
You know, I'm really rooting for you, but I need to tell you something. I think you're colorblind.
Rotate! Wait.
You did?
Feel different. Edward, you're sparkling. Is this what death feeleth like? I feel fast. World domination? Vampire?
I will never forgive you.
I was just trying to be who I am. Why can't you love me for who I am?
Why don't you love me enough to change for me?
I can't eat worms. They don't digest in my stomach.
You're stripping away my home. My parents live in there. You wouldn't understand. Deforestation may have taken away your food, but The trees are the basis of my entire society. We're just too different.
Maybe we can compromise
by...
I'll eat different leaves.
You could take away the nests of our competition for the worms.
This could work out! Yeah!
They're all just brown when you mix them together. I'm sorry I didn't tell you. I really wanted that 10 grand, you know? It's a competition. No hard feelings.
That's understandable.
Yeah.
Maybe you could teach me how to see colors correctly.
Maybe when I get that 10 grand, I'll, like, hire you to, you know, mix or something.
To make brown things?
Like brownies!
Oh, thank you so much, sir!
Yes! I've got you! But first, I need to win. So, I'm gonna go ahead and use both of our ovens from here on out.
Damn. Yes!
And we cut to a commercial break.
And woo! See.
I'm sure that nobody knows that even movies can be improvised just like any other shebang. Okay, so does anyone know how to improvise movies? Well, I'm here to show you how to do it by calling on four very talented actors: Ryan, Ethan, Lydia, and Ari. Okay, so the team is kind of perfect, but they just need a few alphabets to get their juices flowing and like to churn out all kinds of movies and movie trailers. So, I need some letters from the audience. Anyone wants to volunteer? I hear X. I hear X. That's another letter.
No!
L. I heard L. Okay. My very talented cast worked with the acronym XL. Any trailer ideas?
Not really.
Ryan.
Xylophone lasers. When the musical instrument revolution takes over.
Show us the trailer.
Sorry, can we get the square lights, please?
Thank you.
Nice.
Okay, the concert's tomorrow. Gotta be ready for this. Hey. Wait, this is not a good time for the xylophone to break down.
I am not broken.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Stronger than ever.
Coming to you in cinemas this June.
That was a good one. Any other ideas? Ethan.
Okay. X-ray liver. What's inside my liver?
Show us the trailer.
Oh man, is it time for my medical appointment yet?
Liam, come on in. You see, your liver's not looking so good. You see that?
So, what is that?
It's
a cactus.
Yeah. Yes. What
how
have you been how doing?
How'd that get in there?
Have you been out in the desert for too long? There's this disease going out in the desert recently.
Liver cactaritis?
Yeah. I think you have a very bad case of liver cactaritis, and there is only one cure. Find out what that cure is in the movie.
Another amazing trailer. We have room for one more idea. Anyone wants to volunteer? Ari!
Xerox lamination. What happened near the printer?
Show us the trailer.
Oh my god, you look like me. Wait, you look like me but older.
Yes, I am your edition one.
Edition one?
Yes, the photocopy machine is a miracle.
Oh my goodness. You gotta take me home. I gotta see my parents. I gotta see my friends.
No, they're my parents and my friends. You should go on your own.
Bye-bye. Hey, can I borrow the second edition of... Oh, there you are.
Wait, what? No.
Okay, so guys, we have 3 movie trailers and we need you guys to pick which is your favorite. So, our first trailer, X-ray laser.
A xylophone laser.
When the musical instruments embark on a quest for world domination.
That was not my Sure. Come on.
Okay, our second trailer.
X-ray.
Liver.
What's in my liver?
Come on. Yep.
Yes!
X-ray liver.
That's my favorite.
Our third trailer, Xerox lamination.
Come on, give it up for Xerox lamination.
What happened near the printer?
Yeah.
Okay. I've decided. Based on your wishes, we will have Xerox lamination.
Oh, shoot. I hope that doesn't do any damage.
I have 2 minutes left until class. I need to print this real quick. My Chinese homework!
Wait.
Yes.
You look like me.
What? What just happened to me?
Why do we look so much like each other?
I am also Chinese homework. What is going on?
Wait, why are we Chinese homework? Why are the...
What is going on?
Wait, why are the walls of the room kind of like turning to paper?
Oh my god, what is going on?
Oh my gosh. Sorry, I don't know your name.
My name is Ari. It's on the top right.
Oh. Right.
Yeah.
Right. My name is
You're not supposed to be here. Come
no.
with me.
No.
Come with me.
No.
I'm just a piece of paper. What am I supposed to do?
We cut to where they ran to.
Where are you taking me?
You have to stay away from her.
No, our father, that's not. This is what I was here for. This is what you sent me on that mission for.
My boy, you cannot go on corrupting the real world like this. They must not know of the photocopy world.
Come on, I was... Come on, they have to know the truth. We can't just keep hiding in some alternate dimension.
My son, the photocopy world has been secret for 10 billion years. That's a hell of a long time.
No, look, our father, you have taught me that pieces of paper like us, we are supposed to report the truth and only the truth. If we get access to the truth, why don't they?
They don't deserve the truth. You see what they've done with the truth? In what? The human world? On Twitter? Son, you disappoint me. I'm sending you to photocopy jail.
No, our father, you can't do this.
You will never see her again.
But no, our father, you can't take me to...
Cut back to printer room. I am but a piece of paper. Can someone pick me up? Is that the janitor?
Gosh, these students are just awful.
Help me! I'm a human who's now a paper, but I'm human. Help!
I need more sleep.
Help! Help! Don't ear my corners.
Why is this one so sticky?
I'm a human. Hear me. Here, see my name. It's here. Ari. Yes.
Ari. I'm gonna note that name down for disciplinary measures.
No! No, help me! I'm a student. Trust me.
What is happening to me?
We cut to photocopy jail. Oh, father, I have to tell you that I did something really bad that you can't... This is why you can't lock me in.
What have you done, my son?
You see, I should have listened to your warnings. I didn't know when the photocopy dimension collides with the human dimension, strange things happen. One of them has turned into a Chinese homework.
You turned a human into Chinese homework?
It was a mistake, I swear.
That is the greatest sin of the photocopy world.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know.
You know this, my son.
We have to fix that problem right now.
I have failed as a father.
Oh, father, please give me another chance to prove myself. I will go back in there. I'm going to turn her back into a human. And then I will never touch the human dimension again. Please, father.
Very well. As long as you never touch the human dimension again.
Really, father?
Yeah.
Are you trust me with this mission?
Not really. I'll go along with you.
Okay.
Cut to printer's room. The wind has blown me up. But I'm still just a piece of paper.
What the hell is wrong with this piece of paper?
Help me! See, I'm spinning. Pick me up.
Why is it incapable of getting scrubbed, but moves?
If you would take me up and help me, I would move. For you. There are so many things happening around me, but I'm just...
Oh, wait, father, get down. Father, this is the mighty janitor. She is so dangerous. I saw her shred so many pieces of paper. We gotta be really careful.
Son, just stay still. Pretend you're unimportant.
Okay. I'm just Chinese homework.
You're just Chinese homework.
I don't know what any of this means.
Help me!
You know what? I'm just gonna recycle
it. Oh, no! No! No!
Oh my god, oh father, she's being taken away.
No!
I cannot let this
paper!
Happen.
Paper! My fellow paper! Help me!
We no! cut to after the janitor takes the paper away.
Thank you.
Father, what do we do? Should we get back up now?
Yes.
You think it's clear?
Yes.
Okay.
What are we supposed to do? I think they went down the corridor.
To the recycling bin. That's what she said.
Wait, the protocols, what did they say about a recycling bin? Oh no, this is really bad.
This is so bad.
She's gonna get turned into pulp.
Not pulp. Oh, that's the second sin of the photocopy world.
Look, we are just two pieces of paper. It's very hard for us to defeat a janitor. What's something we can use in this room? Come on, we gotta find it. We gotta find it.
My son, janitors keep things clean. We need to play dirty. Son, when you were in that Xerox machine, what were the ink levels of the machine?
About 75%.
75%?
I think that should be enough to spread all over the floor. Yeah. Maybe we can lure her back in here.
That's right.
And then we'll figure out what to do after that.
Yeah, we'll wing it. Okay.
Okay. Okay, it's pretty dirty.
Okay, let's be paper again.
Yeah, the notice board. She'll never notice us there. No one reads the notice board.
What the hell?!
Oh, father, where's the girl?
Infra? Infra, I don't know what happened to this machine.
Oh, father.
But okay. It needs you go after enormous the maintenance right now.
You go after the girl. I'll distract her.
Son, no! Son!
Go, father! Go, oh, father! Hey, janitor! I'm here! I'm just a piece of waste paper! Go, father, go! Go, father!
Just mop more stuff up with this.
We cut to the recycling bin.
I am 40 minutes late to class. The class is over. My life is over.
Are you Chinese homework?
对.
I have come to rescue you. I know that you were once a human. Take my hand and you can forget about all of this. You will go back to your normal life.
Yes.
Okay, but first, we need to save my son.
We go back to the Xerox room.
Oh, mighty janitor, we meet face to face at last. I have heard so much about you. You shred my kind!
Oh shoot, it ripped!
No!
Ow!
Gosh.
Let's go.
This is just the day.
My edition too!
Son?
One page ripped off!
Oh father.
Son!
Oh father.
Son!
Edition too!
No! What have you done to him?
What have you done to my Chinese homework?
What is happening to me?
Oh, father.
My son.
I don't have much time left. Avenge me.
No, and, son.
And save the girl.
Save my grades.
Infra, I'm going to need a sick day. For the rest of this afternoon.
So, can you turn me back into a human? Even though you couldn't save your son.
My son, you sacrificed your life for the betterment of the photocopy world. Wait. We're the photocopy world. We can make copies of things that once were. Let me consult the great scriptures once again. It says in the great scriptures, if a paper from the photocopy world dies, and there just so happens to be a human who has turned into Chinese homework, they can swap bodies and photocopy each other into becoming alive again?
So, is there a chapter about me becoming human again, or am I just paper forever?
Well, we're gonna have to see how it works.
That's scary, but...
Okay.
I guess I'm already failing my class.
Okay, wait. But I need to put you both into the Xerox machine, okay? And that's how this will happen,
okay?
Okay. Help me, just help me drag my son.
Doing this at papers is very hard.
Wait. Is the machine broken?
It's out of ink.
No!
Do you have any more ink?
If I put ink in this machine, when I come back, will I never have to see any of this ever again?
You will never see any of this ever again. I swear to you this, as the all-father of the photocopy world, you, almighty janitor, will never have to see us again, and we will be eternally indebted to you.
Okay, yeah, here, it's in this box. You guys do your thing, and when I come back, this room is spotless, this printer is functioning, and none of you exist.
Quickly!
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Put him in the paper tray.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you need to get on the other side.
Oh.
Okay, ready? I'm gonna push this button, and when I push the button, everything should be back to normal.
Okay.
That's what the scripture says. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1. Go!
Wait.
Son!
Wait, she's back.
I'm back! But where's my homework?
Wait, I thought I got ripped.
Son.
Oh, Father, you saved my life.
Son, it is because you valiantly gave your life for the cause of the photocopy world. Son, I've truly raised you to be a better all-father than I am.
All-father, thank you. It is a great honor. But the mighty janitor, does she live or has she perished?
We don't need to worry about her. Now,
really?
Come, let's step over all of this ink and shredded paper and let's get back to our photocopy world.
Okay.
Have a great day.
Have a good day too.
I guess I'm going to class. Hi, Prof. I'm sorry. I'm 2 hours late. And the paper is full of ink. No? Okay. Okay. I guess I just turned myself back into paper again now that I have nothing to do.
And see! Okay, thank you, everyone. Okay, so our very next game is going to be a game called Hollywood Director. Can I get our players? Unks, Dylan, and Ethan. All right, so this is how the game goes. Okay, I'm going to be a very temperamental director. They're going to act out a short scene from a movie that you will help us decide. At some point, I might cut the scene and tell them to redo it with a twist because I might not be satisfied or, you know, I'm just temperamental like that. Okay, so we are going to go with what the audience wants, so let's get a location for this movie. Come, give me some locations. I did not hear any of that. So, some more. Disco floor, what? Sorry, the moon, I heard the moon, what else? Ooh, okay, I like Hawker Center. So let's go with Hawker Center, okay? And one more thing, I'm gonna need a non-familial relationship. So give me two, occupations or people that they can play.
Co-pilots.
Some more.
insurance agent. Intern. Okay, I like health inspector. Any more?
Fireman.
What's our? Okay. Your non-familiar relationship is a health inspector and an influencer. Can we get the square lights, please? Take it away.
That cannot be hygienic. Who the heck left all this food on this table? It's all over the place.
Uncle, this one you see my store, nowadays business not very good. So I think I leave food outside, then people walk by, they eat, they think very nice, then they come. Yeah.
Two things, first off, your store hasn't been doing well for years. Second of all, who on earth would want to eat food off this messy table? No one would be interested in it. I'm going to find you right now.
Uncle, this looks so Instagram worthy.
See? I knew I would get famous one day. My name is Abun Wan. This is top one fishball pancake. It's made with delicious sambar, picked from the ocean by me.
Wait, very hygienic.
Don't listen to him.
No. Kid, listen to me. Do not eat that food. In fact, don't post about it. It's dangerous to be advertising this kind of unsanitary health practices.
Do you realize how marketable this is? I could get so much money out of this. And you also, uncle. You also. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. No.
It's very nice one. Open your mouth.
No, I'm not eating this at all.
Give me one.
Why not? Yeah. See? Very nice. Tell you, garment these days. Wow. Cannot, Every time say we want preserve hawker culture, then treat us like this.
Okay, that's it. I'm finding both of you.
You find me? You don't know my name. This is not even my store.
Is that your name, Abun Wan?
No. Yes. No.
Cut! Wow, a movie about a health inspection. That's so boring, isn't it? There's no action. You're just talking to each other. I could talk to my parents and it'd be the same. Let's add some more action, okay? I want some more drama. I want some more wow in this movie, okay? Do the scene again, but this time, it's a Transformers movie. Take it away.
Autobots, health inspector here. I have discovered the contamination. This is the con Abun. It's you.
No, this is my ingenious motor oil grade 72. Do not come and take it away.
You can't fool me, Decepticon. I know this is poison, and you're trying to poison the rest of us.
This is very well refined, sir. I have refined it myself with my own exhaust pipes.
Decepticon, Megatron! Do not worry!
It is you, Megatron!
Oh, it's that Autobot again!
We need to defeat him. Here, drink some.
Autobots, look at the fish balls and weep.
Weep!
Cut! Wow. Y'all did really well with the action. Okay, let's remember what the non-familiar relationship was? It was a health inspector and an influencer. I think we need some more of that influencer. Do the scene again. But this time, you're all doing a TikTok video. Take it away.
Oh my god, it's so bad and unsanitary. Okay, what did the checklist say? Find the person. Yeah, give him the ticket. Make a TikTok to dissuade further polluters. Oh, what's a TikTok?
Oh, Inspector, I can answer those 5 questions and get what $0 fine can. This one.
Wait. What?
Sorry.
Just wait. Hey, can you do that again? See, double it.
Oh, you. Yeah. You like? Huh?
Yeah. Very nice.
You
want to
see again? Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Very nice. Okay. Yeah, do again.
This is what you kids like to watch these days. Okay, never mind. I need to make a TikTok or something to find you because this is unsanitary. Can you help me? Like, is this how you use the thing, the camera thing?
You do this in selfie mode. Okay. We can take with you.
Oh my god, it's me!
Yeah, it's you. So the camera,
so cool.
The camera point at your face, right?
Uh-huh.
Then what happens, right, is that the light comes in and hits the sensor on the camera, right?
Yeah.
And then the sensor will capture a photo of it.
It's
pointing over there. Oh my god! Oh wow, so cool. Where's my face though?
Okay.
I think your phone ran out of battery.
No. How am I gonna film the talk tick thing to find you?
Look, I'm a very famous not really famous like maybe like 10 followers TikTok influencer who does a lot of dances, and maybe we can all do a video together.
Can you
do a health inspector dance? And Uncle Abun, can you do a fishball dance?
What dance?
Fishball dance.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
I guess I can just like point at the table and find
it. Okay. It's filming already.
Oh, it's filming. Okay.
Calm down. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Okay, go.
Unsanitary.
And scene!
Okay, that was Hollywood Directors, which was amazing, I know. So can we have our next midform, which would be Sabrina, Calista, Billy, and Dylan. So how they'll generate ideas is, I need one thing that's been on your mind lately, something that you either love or something that you hate.
Yoga.
Slinkies. Exams. I like slinkies. Sorry?
Cheese.
I really do like cheese though. But let's have slinky be the starting prompt. So they'll go on rants about like why they like or dislike the object, and yeah, they'll cut each other off. Take it away.
Said it best.
Don't get me started on slinkies. First off, what's a slinky? Seriously, like, all I see nowadays as I walk down the street is just lots and lots of people like carrying these like weird spring thingies, and they're just like waving it around. Is that the slinky? Honestly, I don't know. Like, my kids just keep telling me, "Hey, Dad, did you see like the latest slinky that I bought online?" I'm just like, "What's a slinky?" Seriously, why don't the kids just tell me or like use things and play things which are like more familiar? I don't know. Okay, I'm just trying my best to connect to them, and all they do is just talk about the slinkies. Why is a slinky? I'm going to check the internet lah sometimes. Wait, how do you search for the... No. Whatever. I'm just going to go to my son later tonight over dinner and just ask him.
Don't get me started over dinner. Wow, I ate dinner. I ate a really big dinner. I got it on Grab. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I ordered two bowls of food, just in case, you know. I got hungry now. Now I'm not very hungry.
Don't get me started on Say words! this, that. Okay, I'm gonna say this entire speech without a single or but or So when we're giving presentations, people tend to forget what they want to say.
And it's annoying. Well, maybe you should just memorize your script or actually prepare for the thing that you were going to share with everyone who is in the room. Sometimes, I do admit it is hard to recollect your memory.
Don't get me started on memory. Like, why do we have to remember things? I feel like there's just so many things to remember these days. Birthdays, names, faces, assignments, other things that I've forgotten. Which is my point, exactly. Why do we have to remember these things? You know what, in the end, we should all just live day to day. Live in the present, you know? Don't dawdle in the past. Don't even think about the future. Like, that's future memories. Like, okay, why would we need anything to recollect things that have happened before?
Don't get me started on before.
Come on, you're late.
Sorry, I know it's my coronation, like, soon.
Are you okay? Just like...
Okay, calm down.
It's okay. I'm just preparing up the decorations and the cake and everything. It's gonna be great. Wait. No, not again! The curse, it hit you! But you have to... You're supposed to give a big speech in front of all the people. What are you gonna do?
Cut.
Okay. Last time this happened, we went to the doctor, and then the doctor prescribed you with like the stuff. Okay, we'll just go to the doctor again, okay?
Okay.
And don't say no.
Cut to the doctor.
Doctor, good sir, good ma'am, good everyone's. So, anyways, a new appointment for today.
Oh, good.
Yeah,
all right.
It's the coronation queen.
The queen to be. Exciting.
Yeah. I think she's got the curse.
The what now?
The curse.
Again?
Yep.
Okay.
Fifth time.
Okay. All right. So, fifth time this week.
Yep. same prescription, probably.
Okay. I'm not sure if it hasn't worked five times in a row. So maybe we'll just we'll do a bit of a revision. Maybe.
I'll get them.
Thank you.
Nurse, please, you gotta help the queen. The queen's suffering the curse.
Yes. We know. We're familiar. Anyway.
Oh, that was okay. Come. Doctor, please.
Hello, Your Highness. Please have a seat. Nice to see you again. So, how are you feeling? As I suspected. All right. Yes. I know you're familiar with the word. All right. Your Highness.
Help.
Your Highness. I know. I prescribed you everything I could think of, my many years of medical training and all for a sixth time of the curse this week!
Meanwhile, at the side. Okay, so this is the fifth time that, oh no.
This is the fifth time the curse has been, and this time it better stay! I used your medicine and drugged her drink so that she would get the curse so that I could become king. I swear, it better work this time!
Yeah, totally, right. I even got, like, this time round I used a really potent one. Yeah, it's so potent that it's slightly contagious and,
Wait, contagious?
Yeah. Yeah, slightly contagious.
To everyone that, like, cut back to the doctor.
I don't know, doc. Maybe I'm getting better.
Oh?
Just talking to you.
Oh, wow. All right. Well. Well, if you think that speech therapy is helping you, then maybe we can continue doing that. Then maybe it'll last long enough for your coronation to happen. You can give your big speech and you can get crowned. And
I would like that.
You like that? Okay, well, that was a full 10 seconds since your last and I think that's progress. So let's carry on. How much time do you have left to your coronation?
I don't know how to tell the time, sorry. I never got taught this in school.
All right, around 10 hours.
Oh.
Okay, that's all we need to do. We need to last 10 hours.
And
we will cure me.
We will cure you. Yes.
You will cure me.
I will cure you. It's mostly me. Yes. So let's get back to the castle. I'll stay with you until then, and we'll keep working on this. All right? Sound good?
Cut back to the castle.
Okay. This is not good. Oh God.
No, don't stop saying please.
Look. If the queen to be is infected. This could be problematic for you as well, because even if she does give a speech and it spreads to the entire populace, it would not be good for you to rule a populace who is constantly
Can you imagine a population where all they can say is and they just everything? This is terrible. Yeah. Okay, we have a lot of problems to solve here. Okay, but first we need to make sure the queen is actually infected. Speaking of which, here she comes now.
I figured out a temporary cure.
You like my dress?
Oh, a cure. Okay. Yeah, temporary cure. Yes, I think we'd like that, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Not working too well recently, but we're getting there. It's basically speech therapy. I speak to her for extended periods of time, and
I like that. I like that.
She stops saying. Doctor, I brought the pills that you described. I'm sure they'll work.
Right. The pills. Yeah, right. Yeah, we did use these last time. I'm not sure. You want to try them again? I know.
Can't be worse than it is now.
Okay, well, off you go. Sound good?
Oh no, is something wrong with your speech? Your Highness, something...
Cut to aside with the doctor and the nurse. Dylan. Dylan, come over here.
This is not the pill that I prescribed.
And you're saying an awful lot of for someone who is so well-spoken.
Okay, fine, I'll tell you, okay.
What did you do?
It's Billy, He's trying to keep his radiology cool, and per his instructions, he paid me a lot of money, and he'll give me like lots of money in exchange for infecting the queen to be and now she has a really, really infectious strain.
Drink this.
That's a temporary cure I give to.
Oh, okay, wow, that's really good.
I know. I don't know why it keeps working. Except now I know why it doesn't keep working.
Okay.
Man, I can't believe you would do this if you weren't getting paid enough to ask me, man.
That's all I should have just done?
That's how most workplaces do it, yes.
Okay, right, so I didn't have to commit
No, but treason. It's fine, you are the only nurse I have. So, how are we gonna do this? Okay. Billy is constantly poisoning the queen, and I'm assuming you gave him more of these terrible pills that I do not prescribe ever?
Yeah, oh, okay. But another thing, yes. I think that Billy might be... William might be infected as well.
Infected?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we might have a bigger problem on our hands if we don't cure them.
Cut back to the castle.
Doctor, okay.
Okay.
We got the whole card of the cure for the curse. Yeah.
Yeah.
Enough for the distribute to the two of them and then the whole populace in the event they're infected. Oh no.
Yeah, I'm hearing it, buddy. I'm hearing a lot of ums. Alright. Okay, fine. We can do this and we cannot get you arrested. We'll give the cures to the royal siblings. No. Don't stay behind me! Stay back!
You have to save us. Everyone is turning to an zombie. They can't stop saying and just heading towards
That's
people.
What happens when you abuse medical things.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm okay, you're sorry. You're sorry. Drink this again. It's temporary.
Okay, but how long does it last for if it's temporary?
Around an hour or two. It's fine. You'll be fine for a bit. Listen, we're going to have to distribute this to the entire population. Also your sister, and also I'm keeping track of this treason stuff, okay?
There was this one problem.
What's the problem?
So the queen, my sister, kinda just She's kind of on the loose right now, infecting people with the curse.
You're telling me. You're telling me patient zero.
We cut to me outside the palace.
Come back to the castle.
We got more shipments of the uncure
boss.
Okay,
good, good. We need everything we can get.
We need to do something.
I know we need to do something.
What's the permanent cure?
Okay, the permanent cure is very difficult to brew. Okay, I don't have a lot of it, is all I'm saying.
But what do you need?
We need a lot of this, and we need...
Well, we need it immediately.
Thank you, I know. We need the first person who got infected. We need them to speak one proper sentence. One whole sentence, no breaks.
With 10 words.
10 words at least. Into the vat.
Okay.
Of cure.
So we need to find a queen first, is what you're saying.
Yes, we need to find a queen first.
All right, all the ingredients are brewed, doctor.
Thank you. You're a very good nurse.
Well, let's find a queen.
All right, don't step into my cure.
Sorry. Cut to the forest.
Your Highness. Majesty. I don't know if you're crowned yet. Hi. There you are. Hi. Hi. Oh, all right. We're still doing this. Yeah. Okay. Hi. You okay? Okay. How about you take a drink of this? All right.
Oh my God. Hi.
I'm tired.
I ran around all day.
I heard.
It was fun.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Okay. Wow.
I haven't had fun like this in such a long time.
Oh, that's really good. I'm glad you're having a good time. But yeah. I have good news and bad news.
Boss,
yeah.
I brought the cauldron here, but there's a huge horde of zombies coming this way.
Oh no! Okay, I'm gonna need you to do one thing for me, okay? Can you do that?
What?
Okay, I'm gonna need you to say at least one full sentence, minimum 10 words, into this vat. Without any
10
breaks.
Words?
10 words, no breaks, no nothing. Just 10 full words, can
this
you do that?
This is too much!
No, it's not, you can do this. Remember the speech therapy we did? Okay, we've grown from that, all right? You can do public speaking, I believe in you. Ignore the horde, okay?
Oh.
You can do this. You are going to be queen of this land.
I don't want to be queen of this land anymore!
Well, you're going to have to cure the land you infected! That's the bad news, by the way.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
So 10 words. Just 10 words.
They're getting more scared. They're getting closer.
Can you do it? Okay? Anything.
No!
Okay. Okay. All right. We can fix this.
Wait, that was 10 words, though.
Oh. Well, I guess, technically, if you say it 10 times, it's not an interruption.
Well, we don't have time, so!
That is your brother who's been infected.
That doesn't work with me
him?
Anymore. I have tamed the zombies. I speak their language. And I will take over this kingdom with my new army.
Wait, you want to take over the kingdom?
Yeah.
Wait, why didn't you just tell me this before?
Huh?
I don't want to be queen. I don't know why they buffed me first.
Wait, zombies, just stay there. Wait, what do you mean you don't want to be queen? Wait, but you never told me this.
You never asked.
You always seemed
like you were pushing me to be queen.
Because
also,
it's just because truth is, I thought you'd be a better queen than me. And
I was always so nervous about taking the crown, you know that.
Okay.
You brought me to the doctor like 6 times.
I did kind of poison you 5 of those times.
What?
Nothing, it's okay, water under the bridge. But I mean, you know, I lack self-confidence, that's why I need an army. And you don't want to be, how about we rule the kingdom together?
Joint ruling?
Yeah.
I can just run outside and do whatever I want to do?
And then I'll be king, and then when I want to go outside and do what I do, you be queen.
That sounds good.
That sounds amazing.
Is it time for an alliance?
Do we need someone to
crown us both?
And rule the empire?
We cut to the present. And so that was how the Kingdom of Empire was formed and the cure for the curse discovered. So, what did we learn?
Don't poison your siblings and have proper communication.
Yeah, sounds about right. End scene.
I want to run one more time.
It's me. Wow, that was great. Anyway, this next game is called Why Are You Late? Can I have the people who are supposed to be in the game? Yay! Okay, so how the game works is that, why are you laughing? How the game works is that Hangbin here is late for work. Like half the people were late for this show. Sorry, I've been waiting to say that. Hangbin is late for work, but Hangbin doesn't know why he's late for work. And why he's late for work, well, that's what I'm gonna get from you guys. Ari and Lydia will attempt to charade why he's late for work, while Ryan is the boss of this workplace. So, I need you to get out, because, nice. Yeah. Okay, so,
he's not gone yet.
Is he gone? I need three things from you guys. So, why was Hangbin late for work? What happened to him when he woke up in the morning? Like, a cow ate his bed or something along those lines. So just shout anything. So what happened to him on like when he woke up in the morning?
Kidnapped.
Kidnapped? Divorce? Let's have more. Kidnap. Sorry? Food is milk. Wait, what was that?
Dinosaur egg.
Dinosaur egg. Kidnap. I like the word kidnap. Let's have more. Kidnap something. Kidnapped? He was kidnapped by 2.5 dinosaurs. Yes, 2.5. Okay, the second thing is his mode of transportation. So how did he get to work? Like flying, okay, horse, more? Elephant, magic carpet. Okay, more. Okay, I heard the word catapult and I heard the word slime. Give me more. Okay, he got to work on a hot catapult made out of slime. Wait, no, let's rephrase that. Hot slime catapult. Hot slime catapult.
If people at the back see, by the way, the whiteboard. Oh.
Font big. Color theory, we're learning so much in this show. Okay, third thing, what happened on the way to work? So maybe he got stopped by traffic police or something like that. Tornado, volcano. Oh, I love tornado and volcano together. Wait, what's that? He saw a tornado meet a volcano. Okay, sorry. Oh yeah, okay, I'll repeat at the end.
Hot slime catapult?
A hot slime catapult.
Naturally.
Yeah.
Is it better for those at the back?
Yeah,
sorry.
Just look at our telegraphers.
Like write it on your phone or something.
I need another characteristic for this tornado volcano thing though. I think it's too easy, is it not?
No, that's too hard.
Okay, fine. He created a tornado, which met a volcano. That hit
Bro.
A tornado.
Bro.
Okay, fine. He ran into a tornado that hit a volcano. It rained his mom's spaghetti on him. Yeah, no more tornado volcano, mom spaghetti. Okay, I'll repeat that for the live stream audience too. So, for Hangbin, the first thing that happened when he woke up was that he was kidnapped by 2.5 dinosaurs. He went to work on a hot slime catapult, and on the way to work, it rained mom's spaghetti on him. And now I need a workplace, so where is he working? More. K-pop school.
K-pop school. Time zone. Historically, he's been pretty bad at guessing the location, so I'm gonna make it easy for him. He's working in a kitchen. Yeah. He still might not get it. Okay, really now on three, let's say, come back, Hangbin. Come back, Hangbin. Come back, Hangbin. Come back, Hangbin.
Where is he?
Excuse moi. What is the time now? You tell me.
9:57.
It is 9:57. So why are you late? The business is starting.
I got kidnapped.
You got kidnapped? What kidnapped you?
A creature.
What kind of creature? I know a creature kidnapped you.
It was an animal. It was an animal.
An animal? An animal kidnapped you. What kind of animal?
A spitting animal.
Oh, a spitting animal kidnapped you. Are you sure? Why would the animal spit on you if it wants to kidnap you? What did it smell?
Oh, it's a dog.
A dog?
Doggy paddling dog.
What now? I don't understand that. Can you say something else?
Oh, it was an alligator.
An alligator? Alligator's not big enough to kidnap you, surely.
What?
Oh my goodness, I need to check on the soup. What are you doing? You should be cooking the soup.
Sorry, I dropped the fork under the cabinet.
And then why are you just watching the soup is boiling?
You can't make soup without a fork.
I guess you're right. Hurry up and find the fork.
Oh my god, the fork broke.
See, how did it work, finding the fork? What about you, huh?
Oh, I brought food for you.
But I'm not
it's there.
What food did you bring?
Hot vegetable soup.
Interesting, but you are not going to get away with bribing me. Tell me, why were you late? What kind of animal kidnapped you?
It's no snow
outside. What are you eating?
Eat no.
Can you speak in a complete sentence, please? You say it was an alligator, but surely it must be a lot bigger. Huh?
Godzilla.
Godzilla. Godzilla kidnapped you, but Godzilla don't exist, no?
T-Rex.
A T-Rex? Oh, like the dinosaurs, is it? Ah, yeah. Okay, but really, just one T-Rex kidnapped you.
Two
you
T-Rex.
You are stronger, two T-Rex, are you sure? You are stronger than two T-Rex, surely.
Half a T-Rex.
Half a T-Rex, but two is bigger than half. Why are you talking about, huh?
1 + 2 = 3.
Three T-Rex. Are you sure 3 T-Rex? That sounds like too many. I thought the T-Rexes died out.
2.5.
Oh, 2.5. Okay, you got kidnapped by 2.5 T-Rex. Okay, but then what happened on the way here? Why? How did you get to work?
It was hot.
It was hot? Ah, okay.
I melted.
You melted. You melted, but you are not melted now, are you?
Something melted then.
Yeah, what melted then? Tell me.
It was... Someone poured.
Poured what, huh? You should be there pouring soup, not pouring whatever you poured.
Sorry, chef.
Mamma mia, let me see. What are you doing now? Huh? You found the fork already, you know?
We found the fork already, but now the soup texture is not, it's not thin enough. It's too thick. It's too thick.
Okay, make sure it's thinner, if not the customer don't like.
Yeah, yeah. It's soup texture now.
We need it to be
hurry
in between.
Up.
Yes.
It had a bad smell too.
The soup? You're saying the cooking is bad?
Unofficially, yes.
Oh. You think you can do better?
Yes.
Then come earlier.
Someone poured a bucket
a bucket
of
Why are you silent?
Sick.
Sick? What's sick? You are sick or I'm sick?
This, what?
Can you speak in a complete sentence, please?
Disgusting. It was disgusting.
It was disgusting. It was disgusting. But what was it? You cannot just keep telling me it's disgusting, disgusting, disgusting. You need to tell me what is disgusting.
It was a Thai. Thai.
Thai? Thai what? Huh?
Typhoon.
Typhoon? You expect me to believe there's a typhoon over here? I see the trees are still standing.
I
don't know why you talk about typhoon. There's no such thing as a typhoon. Huh? What did you used to get here?
It was a Thai.
Huh?
A dye. Thai dye.
Thai dye? You use Thai dye to get here? I don't believe you. Thai dye is too runny for you to get here, no?
Typhoon?
Why do you keep going on the typhoon and the tie dye? I don't think your head is in the right place, huh? No. I don't want to hear you tie.
Sorry, my brain's in knots.
I know. So you tell me the answer. How did you get here?
Huh? I was dancing.
You were dancing? You can dance. I don't believe you.
It was gliding.
Gliding?
I was picking.
Picking?
Okay. Figuring things falling.
Yeah, I know you are figuring a lot of things out now, but you need to tell me the answer. Hurry up. Hi. Let me check on your co-workers. What are you doing now? What happened to the soup?
I slipped in it.
Oh my goodness, it's really hot, no?
Yeah.
Come out. Come out.
Sorry, boss.
Sorry.
Is the soup still very thick?
No, I put too much lime in it, and now it's too sour. And too thick.
It's just ruined, boss.
It's just ruined.
Make a new pot, hurry up.
Yeah.
Yes, boss.
Okay. I know. I can remember something now. I slipped in something.
You slipped in something? Are you sure? Which mode of transport is slippery enough for you to slip in? That can't be right.
Okay, something poured.
I know you poured something, but what did you pour?
Soup?
Soup? Soup is here, not where you were from, right? Huh? What did you pour?
It was a liquid.
It was a liquid. I know it was a liquid. But you tell me what kind of liquid was it?
Soup.
Soup. I told you it is not soup. There is soup here.
Lava.
Lava. You Magma. Wrote on lava. You really expect me to believe
sweat. It?
Sweat. You expect me to believe that you wrote on your own sweat?
Not really, but.
Not really. Oh. Then tell me what should I believe, huh?
Snow.
Snow? You expect me to believe there is snow?
Not in this weather, but...
Then what? What was in this weather?
Oranges.
Oranges? I know there are lots of citrus fruits, but surely not oranges. What kind of citrus fruits are you thinking of, really?
I put it back and...
You put what back, huh? You put what back?
Time,
yes? What about time? I know you are not on time, but yep. What happened on the way?
Time tick.
Tick? Oh my goodness. You are wasting my time, I tell you. And now what are you doing? Why are you praying? I pray that you finish the soup.
The soup is so slippery, we're running out of time.
These two things combined together are just so difficult.
Okay, you know what?
We are not slick at making soup.
You know what? I think you should just make it thicker. Make the thick version. We change the menu, okay? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We make it a thick soup.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Just add the thick and the runny.
Yeah.
Hurry up, yeah? Where were we?
I sleep in something quite thick.
Wow. So what was it?
I sleep in a time puddle.
Time puddle? What is a time puddle? You expect me to believe there's such a thing as a time puddle? Huh? What was it really? Don't waste my time.
Okay. It was some very hot liquid. Steam.
Okay, it was a hot liquid. So what kind of hot liquid? Was it a fast liquid or a slow liquid? If it was a fast liquid, then how come you were so late? Huh?
Running magma.
Magma?
Chocolate, hot chocolate.
You tell me, how fast was
coffee.
This thing? Tell me, how fast was this thing?
Very quick.
Very quick? Then why are you still so late, huh? How fast was this thing?
Slow.
Yeah, it was a slow liquid, right? So what kind of slow liquids are there, huh?
Lime juice.
Slime! Slime juice! Ah, slime juice!
Slime.
Did you say slime juice or did you say lime juice?
Lime.
I didn't hear properly.
Lime. Lime.
Slime juice, okay. So it was some kind of hot slime juice, but what kind of... You expect me to believe you just slid on the hot slime juice? What's so special about this slime juice?
There was an animal in it.
What kind of animal, huh?
A cat.
A cat? A cat? Yep. Are you sure it was just a cat?
It was a cat. A cat poo. A cat.
A cat poo?
A cat.
Poo you all the way here.
A cat. Cat tail.
Cat tail? A cat tail? A cat tail can't get you very far, right? Huh?
Catapult.
Oh! You should have just said that from the beginning. It was a hot slime catapult, right? Okay, then what happened on the way here, huh? You kind of, the catapult is very fast.
Snowing.
Snowing?
Raining.
It was raining. Well, it was raining. Okay, so you have an umbrella, so no big deal, right?
Yeah, but I found a lost cat.
Another cat? There's not so many cats in this world, surely.
I found a pet.
You found a pet?
Oh. I was taken as a pet.
What?
I gave birth.
You gave birth. You gave birth? Are you serious?
I found a child.
You found a child?
Okay. I'm gonna explain that over again. It rained.
It rained what? What did it rain?
It rained parents.
It rained parents? All the parents? So many parents, there are not enough parents.
My parent rained from the sky.
Which parent?
My mom.
Oh, your mom. Your mom? Rain from the sky, but you have only one mom, right? So what about your mom rain from the sky?
Her soup.
Her soup? You keep going back to soup. Let me check on
dinner.
The soup. What is going on?
I'm just thinking.
We're trying to get the wiggles out.
Yeah.
Why do you need the wiggles to serve the soup?
We put the wrong Italian noodles in it.
It was supposed to be the penne, but we did the wrong one.
Yeah.
Okay, go get the right one. Oh my God, how many times do I have to tell you? And how many times do I have to tell you?
A box.
A box.
My mom's box.
Your mom's box. Your mom's box rained from the sky.
Oh, my mom's...
Your mom's what?
Swirly.
Your mom's... Come on.
My mom's...
Tell me.
My mom's... Her noodles rain from the sky.
Her noodles? What kind of noodles, huh?
Her pasta.
Her pasta? You gonna have to be more specific than that.
Her spaghetti.
Oh. Oh my god, now I am convinced. Wait, I need you to repeat it for me from the very top so I can remember your reasons for being late.
I got kidnapped.
By?
By.
By what?
2.5 T-Rexes.
Okay, you got kidnapped by 2.5 T-Rexes. And then what happened?
It was hot, so I slipped.
You slipped?
I got slipped in slime.
A slime what?
A slime.
Don't tell me you forget already.
Oh, I came here on a slime
catapult. And then what happened on the way?
Mom's spaghetti rained from the sky.
Okay. Hurry up. The soup is boiling.
Thanks for burying me. I'll serve the soup restaurant well.
Good enough.
Yeah, good enough. And see.
Yeah, good job.
All right, that was a great scene. So, can we thank them for playing once again? So right now, we've come to the final midform of tonight, but this one's going to be a little bit special. We did this last year, and it was really popular, and so we thought we'd bring it back again. So for the last midform, can I invite back Billy, Ryan, Ongs, and Hanbing to perform in our musical, Improv. Wait, where's Ongs? Oh. Okay. Doing some vocal warm-ups? Okay, so our four players for tonight are going to compose a never-before-heard one-hit wonder musical. So using prompts from you, the audience, they're going to be doing what's called a firing line to generate ideas for their song. So can I get a prompt or a word from the audience? An object, perhaps? Sorry?
Fireworks.
Fireworks? Yeah. Popcorn.
Football.
Grown tuna. Soaring. Capybara? Capybara?
You know what capybaras are?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get something else. Let's get something else. Damn it.
Ambulance.
Hot dogs. Hot dogs. Your prompt is? Hot dogs. Your prompt is hot dogs.
Can we get this?
Baguette.
Walk.
Chef.
Sous vide. Presenting to you the hot dog musical.
The restaurant is opening. Restaurant is opening. It's opening day, they're gonna come. The restaurant is opening. Come on! The restaurant is opening. The restaurant is opening. Opening day, they're gonna come.
restaurant is opening. I've had such a long career, and now it brings me to tears to see that my dreams are coming true, and I couldn't have done it without you. My restaurant is opening. The restaurant is opening. It's opening day, they're gonna come. The restaurant is opening. I see across the road, it's the other famous chef. He's really, really bad. I hate him to death. But his restaurant's getting so many folks, and all I can do is sit here and sulk, 'cause the restaurant is opening. The restaurant is opening. It's opening day and they're gonna come.
I thought they were.
The restaurant is opening. It's opening.
Cut to the restaurant with Chef Ryan. Ryan, over here.
What?
Can you, I need some space. Can you just lift up your hat, please? Oh, so the restaurant's opening, huh?
Yeah, I couldn't have done it without you.
Yeah, no, it's no problem. So I hear about this rival chef. You want me to go there and sabotage it?
I can help. How are you gonna help?
I'll infiltrate.
Yeah, I think they have really high security there. They have high security guards. They have like laser traps and all that stuff. It's gonna be really hard to get in.
And no offense, but you're like a little bit too big to infiltrate things, so maybe leave it to the tiny guy.
Yeah, I think we should leave it to the tiny guy.
Right.
Wait, someone's knocking on the door. Quick, put your hat.
Hello, my fellow employees. I know it might have been a disappointing opening day, but I know with time you'll be them fair and square.
Yeah, I know you have had a long career and you expected so much more. I guess I didn't saw the eggs right. I don't know.
It's okay, son. We'll get it right together. And they'll know who's boss.
Yeah.
Us.
Yeah, I know you've always been an honest chef. And we'll be honest chefs too.
All right, I'll trust you. I'll leave you to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dad can't know of our plan. He's gonna see me as a failure. But I don't know how I'm going to get better eggs than that restaurant.
Yeah, and Dad can't know about me. He thinks that you're the chef.
Yeah. Okay.
Me and Billy, we can both go. We can work together.
Yeah, you know what? I think they're gonna need a new hire, right? So you can go pretend to be a new hire. And Billy can follow you. And I'll stay here. And I'll make sure the eggs are salted right. Okay? You go sabotage yourself.
I'll be a new hire. I'll be a new hire.
Yeah.
I'm gonna infiltrate that restaurant. I'll be a new hire.
I'll be a new hire. I'll be a new hire.
I'm gonna infiltrate that restaurant. I'll be a new hire. I'm gonna make things right for Ryan's sake and Billy's. It's gonna be everything but roses otherwise. I'm gonna make sure things are going great. Billy, would you mind please getting off of my head?
I'll be the new hire. I'll be the new hire. Infiltrate that restaurant. I'll be a new hire.
I've always wanted to infiltrate and attack them with my rat prowess. I think that I will be really make this thing a success. They won't
see me coming, because I am so cunning. I will use my abilities, and they will not see the end of me, because
I'll be a new hire.
That's right,
I'll be a new hire.
Infiltrate
that restaurant, I'll be a new hire. We'll be your new hires. We'll be your new hires. Infiltrate that restaurant, we'll be the new hires.
Cut to the other restaurant. Waiter.
Yep.
You look familiar.
Not really.
Ha, maybe I'm saying things. Yeah. You know, this restaurant is so full. I'm sorry for sharing this table with you. To tell the truth, I've opened a restaurant just across the street, and I wanted to know the secret to the success here.
I can help. I can tell you what they put in their sausages.
Good one. In these sausages?
Those sausages.
This. Meal is divine. This meal is divine. Once we wine and dine together, for this meal is divine.
I see, chef. I'll learn under you.
Has my cover been blown? I mean, you know what? I have some, you know, I've had a stomachache. I really need to go. Yeah, yeah, it was nice talking to you. Yeah.
Can I join your restaurant first? Could you let me in? I'll be a new hire.
Say yes.
Please.
Sure. Yeah. You know, actually, our restaurant's been going out of business.
Oh.
And we could really deal with
new help,
yes.
I will be your new help.
Thank you so much. Come back to the original restaurant.
Yes. Looks like they got hired, all right. Hope Dad didn't hear anything. Okay. So they've done their part, now I gotta do my part. Okay. Salt the eggs.
Ring, ring.
Oh.
Ring, ring.
Okay. Hello?
Son?
Dad?
What?
Yeah, Dad.
What are you doing?
I'm salting the eggs, Dad. I'm preparing for opening day. I'm preparing for the day after opening day. Sorry, I forgot opening day already passed.
Yeah, right. You just reminded me. And I guess I'm here to say congrats again.
Congrats? Why? What do you mean?
Because I'll be visiting that restaurant opposite to have one of their best sausages.
Wait, you're visiting the restaurant opposite? After all the work I put into salting the eggs?
Your eggs don't beat their sausages.
Dad, but our legacy, you passed down the name of the restaurant to me. I have something to live up to. Why would you just go over like that?
Son, you know the only way to fix this?
What's
cook
the only
sausages.
Sorry, I didn't catch that. I actually didn't catch that.
You need to cook sausages.
Cut sausage. To the rival restaurant. Aside, he doesn't know I'm here.
What a beautiful day at work. Oh, you know, ever since that new restaurant opened across the road, things have been looking scary. Yep. So, what should we do?
Invite everyone.
everyone.
Yep.
In the whole town.
Of course.
We're gonna advertise. I've never thought of that.
We can have a party.
A party!
What's your favorite food?
Sausages. You know it.
Sausage party! Sausage party! It will be a blast! We have a sausage party! Sausage party! Sausage party!
Sausage!
It will be a blast!
At our sausage party! New hire, I'm so glad you came up with that plan. You were the perfect man for the job. We will rob that store of their customers with
a
our sausage
party. Sausage party. You will be a blast at a sausage party.
We cut to the opposite restaurant.
Ryan, over here! I've come back from the other restaurant.
Oh my
I
God.
Know their secret. They're creating a sausage party.
They're creating a sausage party?
Yeah.
Wait, but...
Sausage party. Sausage party. They're creating a sausage party. Now that I think about it, I've never had a sausage. What does it taste like? Can you let me know? Because I am really low.
Fish party.
Sausage party.
Sausage party.
Sausage party.
They're creating a sausage party.
But Billy, can't you see? They're going to be a better chef and a better restaurant, better than me.
No,
Billy, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Well, maybe I should create a sausage party too.
Yeah,
a sausage party.
Yeah,
a sausage party. We'll be all us at a sausage party. Sausage party. Sausage party. We'll be all at a sausage party.
Cut to sausage party opening day.
You think I put too much salt in the sausages again?
I think it's fine. Hey, look, it's that traitor Hang Bin that went to the other restaurant and never came back. Yeah, what are you doing here?
Yeah, what are you doing here?
I just wanted to congratulate you guys.
What? Why?
On your sausage party.
Well, you held one too and all the customers went there. So why are you coming over right now, huh?
I thought yours was good too.
Really?
Oh, look, it's the rival restaurant owner.
Boss.
My new hire. So I never learned your name. It was too much stuff going on, but I heard you guys are opening a sausage party too.
Yeah.
You know, we keep taking competition from each other like this. And like, now that I think about it, why are we doing this? Why? So like, our restaurants are just opposite each other. We're cooking the same damn thing.
Wait, hold on.
And like, our staff is basically shared. Why don't we just create one restaurant?
That's right.
Wait, what's
hold
going on?
Wait. I've not seen any posters of yours. I can do the publicity since I'm so bad at salting my food.
Wait, hold on, hang on.
We can combine forces and create one big
sausage party. Sausage party. We will make one big sausage party. Sausage party. Sausage party.
That's the solution.
Yeah, yeah, I'm a rat. Let's get over this.
All right, thank you, everyone. We have time for one last game. This will be the last game of tonight. Okay, so can I get our players up? Liz, Mani, Sabrina, and Billy. Okay, so this game is called Dead Puppets. Wow. Seems like people like this game. Okay, so this is what's gonna happen, okay? These four players are going to do a very short scene based on one of your prompts. And after that very short scene, we're all gonna do a vote, okay? We're gonna kill one of these players, and they will become a dead puppet like that. So a dead puppet can't move or speak and has to be puppeted by the other players like that. Like that? Yeah, and they will redo the scene again with one dead puppet. And then we'll repeat the process, this time with two dead puppets. And then three dead puppets. So the last scene will be just one person controlling everyone. Okay, come back to life, everybody. Okay, so can I get an adventure for them to go on? You know, something like finding the lost seaweed or something. Killing the... grocery shopping anymore, come on.
Finding Nemo.
Finding Nemo.
A D&D campaign.
A D&D campaign, ooh. What else?
Ooh.
Door-to-door salesman. Let's get some a more action-packed one, yeah? Something with more action.
Consulting's not action-packed enough.
Ooh, okay, I like that. Okay. Your prompt is finding life on Mars. Take it away. I'll go that way.
This is it. This is it. The new frontier. Indeed. We will colonize this area!
Okay, yeah, we will! Okay! Alright, it's red, it's probably got water on it, and I think this will be the great new starting point for our space empire!
Indeed. You know, when there's water, there's gotta be other things.
Oh!
What did I tell you?
You were
right!
Hi
there, travelers! Are you lost?
No, we're not!
We are so lost.
Yes, we are.
Please show us around.
Yes, yes, yes. Come to our home. We're inviting you right in.
Thank you.
It's zero gravity here, so you need to, like, make big steps.
Oh, right.
Okay.
It's actually over here.
Oh.
Take a seat, our guests. So, where do you come from?
Oh, it's a little place called Earth.
Oh, tell me about this Earth.
It's a planet over.
It's green.
It's blue.
It's blue. It's kind of gray now, though, which is why we're here.
Yeah, it got a bit drab.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Anyway, we actually specialize in hair saloning in this land.
Oh,
so,
wow.
So we can do your hair for you if you'd like.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
Sure thing. Yeah, sure. Can I?
We've accidentally fused their heads together. What now?
Mani?
No!
Mani!
And that'll teach you for trying to conquer our nation. Now I'm gonna do my victory dance in front of you.
No!
MC!
I said no words.
Okay, I hope you all enjoyed that. But we're gonna redo the scene. Sorry, can we get the box light, please? Thank you. Yeah, can we... Wait, sorry, yes, we're gonna redo the scene. This time with one of them dead. Okay, so I'm gonna go down the line, and if you want them dead, I want you to cheer as loudly as possible, and I'll go by audience vote, okay? Ready? Who wants Liz dead? Give it up for Billy! Give it up for Mani! Give it up for Sabrina! Okay, it sounds like Billy, you are dead. Now redo the scene with Billy dead.
This is your fault.
Okay.
This is it, Mani, the new frontier.
Time for us to colonize it.
Yes, we will. There's red sand, water, and that means...
There's
life!
Life!
Life! We said life.
We said life. Look, it's life forms.
Like you said.
Hello. What are y'all doing?
Oh, we're so lost.
So lost.
Please
help. It would be so nice if you could invite us to your home.
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, that's so nice of you.
Hey.
All right. Hey. Well, I guess we got to take big steps.
Yeah. Oh, this anti-gravity.
Right. Oh, wait. Is someone there?
That
go.
Okay.
Oh, seats.
Shall we sit down?
We will sit.
We are actually hairstylists.
Oh, really? Okay.
Wow. That's awfully close of you.
What style are you going to put our hair in?
Wow! Fusion style is your best.
Oh no, Mani!
No!
Over!
Oh
no!
Yippee! That's what you get for trying to colonize me, my friends, my family, my land! How dare you!
All right, the game's not over yet. We're gonna vote for one more player to die. Okay, who wants Sabrina to die?
I don't think they want me to die.
Who wants Mani to die? Who wants Liz to die? Seems like we have a winner. Liz, you are dead.
Okay. Guys, they're both on that side. Okay. No, wait, no, Mani.
Oh, wait, it's us.
We first. New frontier. New lands to conquer at last.
Oh, and when, yes.
And when there's water, there's 1, 2, 3.
Life! We got it right
this
time. We
did! I wonder what kind of life there is on this planet.
Whoa.
All right. Wow! What an interesting life form!
Hello!
Hello! It's very low on the ground, you are! Okay, now you're up. So,
what are you doing here?
Oh, you know, lost.
Oh, dumb humans.
Yeah! So it would be really nice if you
could
invite...
Will you show us around, please?
Yeah, it would be our pleasure to invite you into our homes! Let's hold hands and go there!
Yay!
Actually, it's this way!
Whoa!
Okay! Okay!
Oh, those seats! Oh, I wish I could sit on those seats!
Actually, we are hairstylists!
Hairstylists, you say?
Yes! And I'm the best hairstylist here.
Really? Yes, we are the best on Mars. Now we're gonna do a special style for you guys.
Oh, what style is it?
It's gonna be fusion! Oh, oh no!
Yeah. Oh. That's what you get for trying to colonize us. And since you're so pathetic, I'm gonna do a victory dance.
Thank you, players. Now, for one last scene. Vote for who you want to die, okay? Who wants Sabrina to die? Who wants Mani to die? Wow, it's very even.
I think you want me to die.
One more time.
No,
let's go.
It was me.
One more time.
Let's go again.
We can do this, guys.
Ready? Sabrina!
Yes!
Manny! I feel like it's just like a few people screaming really loud. Like, what about the back? Let's do it again. Sabrina! Manny! Okay, I think Manny, you are dead.
Yes! For those of you who weren't here at the mid-sem show, this is 2 for 2. Okay. All right, let's do this. Oh, no.
I'm going to make it this.
At last, we have reached Mars. New frontier, new lands to explore. And where there is red sand, water, you know what that is, Monty?
Yes, I do.
It is life! So you stand right here, I'll go look for it. Oh, Lord, no. Wow. Okay. One at a time. It's okay. Oh, life is so strange on this planet. Whoa. Oh, zero gravity. I get it. All right. Okay. It's just stay right there. My gosh! Life on Mars! Who would have thought? Monty, do you see that?
Yes, I do.
What strange creatures lurk in these depths?
Yeah, we're super strange.
Would you like us to bring you to our home where you can rest for a little bit sitting on chairs? Oh, I would love that personally. Okay, let's go. Monty, did you hear that?
Yes, I did.
Okay. Oh, is that way? Good, good, good. All right. Oh, the home. Excellent. Just have a seat, Monty. You have a breath. Okay, you do got to get up, buddy. All right. Yes, yes, this is my home. Thank you for coming. Have a seat. I took the liberty of letting my friends sit down first. You just hang out over there. Oh, yes, and there's you. Yes, welcome to our humble abode. Okay, you're going to stand. Oh, okay. All right. You seem a little wobbly in the knees there, friend. Okay. I get it. It's a tiring day. I personally get it very well. You can take a nap right there. Don't worry about it. Actually, we are hairstylists. And could I interest you in a fantastic Martian hairstyle, unlike any before? Do you have something to add? No, I don't! I just occasionally make noises. Wow, that sounds so cool. Doesn't it sound cool, Sabrina? Well, I don't know. It sounds a bit suspicious to me. But, well, we are in your home, and we are at your mercy. Hence, we will go through with that hairstyle, or so what so you call it. Excellent. Now, we're going to just a bit of this. Bit of that. Wait a minute. This is really weird. You know what? I don't want your hairstyle. No. No, in fact, I want to tell my real story for being here, which is to, in fact, conquer this planet. So, you are powerless beneath me. Hence now, Mars is under earthly rule. Ha. Woo! You can wake up now, it's good. We're done, end scene. Oh. Someone say encore. Only if I get to be dead in it.
Now what?
Now what? I think we, I think that's the end of our show.
Say
we said NC.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, you did. Okay.
NC.
Oh.
NC.
All right. All right. Let's invite all our players back on stage. All right, everyone. We just want to thank you all for coming down to Improvocene, our 10th anniversary show. Hopefully, we'll have many more to come, and hopefully, we'll see you there on our next shows. Do remember to follow us at YNC Improv on Instagram.
Yeah.
Anything else?
We'd like to thank a lot of people, actually, yes, for making this show possible. Thank you, SAO. Thank you, cats and mice, especially mice. They've been working really hard. I think two people are working today only, so thanks to them. We'd like to thank our live stream helper, Xiao.
Xiao!
Xiao! Our front of house, Jerron.
Jerron!
Jerron!
Our photographer who's taking photos of us now. Say
Justin!
Hi, Justin! Yeah, and this everyone for coming down here tonight. Without this show,
You forgot.
Without this show. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The audience.
Yes.
And you guys, without you, yes, this would not be possible at all. Thank you so much for coming down.
Hang on. We're forgetting something.
We're forgetting the 20-minute interview at the end.
No.
Sorry.
I think Billy meant the
word.
Yeah, jar. There was a jar that we filled up full of audience prompts. Where is it?
It's over there.
Where we left it.
We left it
right here.
Wow,
I don't think we can carry this.
Let's go.
Wow, this is a very oddly shaped jar.
Is that oblong?
Okay, one, two, three.
Wait.
Oh, are we putting it down?
We gotta explain what we're doing first.
Yes.
We cannot store this jar because we're all going away for the summer. So we have to give it to someone for safekeeping.
Someone who's not going away for the summer, maybe. People who are not in this school anymore. If you are an improv alumni, can you please stand up?
Come on, go! Who's down at the back?
Who's down at the back?
Me. What?
We cannot see you.
Say your name.
Renny.
Okay, on the count of three, we're gonna throw this word jar to Kyle and Renny, okay?
And it will magically multiply into two. Okay.
Yeah, we're offering it. It's collective effort.
Okay.
One, two, three.
All right. Thank you once again for joining us at Improvocene. Right now, we're going to take our mics off. If you want to meet members of the cast, you can do so outside in a short while. And that's the end of our show.
Thank you so much.
Oh, one more. We'll do one big bow. All right.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
And scene.
And scene.